fire.
What are you running?
I'm not ready to start the fire. Almost ready to start the fire.
Amy wants you to start the fire.
See the chat. All
right. Now I'm ready to start the fire.
Lower the back floors.
Let's sit around the floors to start the fire.
Boy, this is a casual gig, huh?
Yeah. Hi, friends. Hi. 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 Hi.
Hello.
Hi.
Also, we're streaming live to Twitch right now, so there's lots of people watching us.
Thank you.
before?
Me.
Me? Oh, wow. Who here has never fucking heard of us ever?
Me. Well, heard of.
Heard of us?
Yeah.
First time seeing us, though.
Yeah.
Well, thank you for coming in. Thank you so
much.
I'm excited for the night. Could we have Black Season Witch? We have Amaranth. Make some noise.
Yeah.
For all the bands on this bill this evening, and thank you, Mulligans, for having us as well. Because, like I said, it's been like 5.5 years. It's been a while. It's been a while. Yeah, it's true. Don't worry, we're not going to do that song. Don't worry. We could, but we're not going to.
We really haven't done it in a while, though.
No.
Don't forget Sound Shop Studio owner.
It's true. Wes Mix. Yes. And so we started our first ever record.
All around nice guy and a badass.
It's better than asshole. He said it, not me.
He's not a bad asshole either.
See, we bring a comedy show too. We're not just, I'm just joking. But we started our first record in January of 2015. It's crazy. And it wasn't supposed to be a band at all. I was just making some music, and Kevin was like, yeah, let's do this. And then we ended up, and then Phil got involved, and then Johnny got involved, and then it's just, it kind of snowballed from there, and now it's been 10 years. Oops. But thank you guys, seriously, thank you so much for coming. If you're liking what you're hearing, liking what you're seeing, we have a merch booth, very small merch booth today. We have all sorts of stuff. And be on the lookout for new merch too, because the next song we're doing, this is a shot in the dark. Does anybody here know who Sabrina Carpenter is?
She's sexy.
Here's the thing. I expected that reaction, okay?
I didn't know until I saw her on SNL.
I don't think any of these motherfuckers knew who Sabrina Carpenter was either. Before I said that we have to cover this next song because it's Espresso. Do you know Espresso?
Yes.
She knows Espresso too. Thank you. Soul sisters in the house. I loved Espresso. And somebody in my Twitch chat, because we stream on Twitch a lot, said it should be EBX Espresso. Like
EBX.
Our band. We're EBX.
Yeah.
So we're about to release it. And we actually have a master as of now-ish.
Yeah.
So look for that on all things soon, all platforms. Outside of their genre, and I saw that this song was getting so viral, and it won like the song of the year at the VMAs, and it's like up for Grammy, I think. So I'm like, let's do it. We gotta fucking do it. So look for that, and spread it all over the interwebs, because it's our next big release. We're finishing shooting our music video for it this weekend as well. So yes, Yes, we're shooting a music video for it. It's half done.
It's Michigan themed.
It's Michigan themed, so you'll see them you'll see some things.
Michigan things.
So you'll see some things from the outside of Detroit. So we're from Detroit. Words are hard, okay?
Words.
From people, you know, words are hard. From people, we know. People who have to talk on microphones, words are hard.
Thank you.
Bye.
be like, we're not going to tell anybody when we make mistakes, but here's the thing, is that Johnny played how much of that without his in-ears in? A little bit. Johnny just played part of that song without his in-ears in. His in-ears in. Please make some noise for Johnny. Years of not having in-ears.
This next one.
I'm still talking about it, even though it's a year and a half old. We made a music video for this next cover tune. We really, really made it our own, and we're so proud of the music video we made for it. It's got over 130,000 views on YouTube, and about the same amount of plays on Spotify, with not a ton of money put into the ads. Like, we're so, so, so proud of how far it went.
But Spotify really pays well, so it's working out for us.
It's a joke.
For
anybody who doesn't know, with that said, we've made $75 on this song.
A bag of salt vinegar chips. Just for dinner.
We got one person got dinner.
I am So excited.
We're crazy that way.
This one's about someone who needs to work.
That's a fact. That's a fact.
We can't say anything else.
When you
legally.
NDA. Legally, we can't say anything else. That's a fact also. When you said that, I was like, really?
According to our lawyer.
We've never done this one. I'm like, oh yeah. I know the set list. I do. We have a few more. We're doing great on time. I think we're going to be able to play everything we planned. Yeah. Which I don't remember the last time that happened.
Never.
It was probably last year.
We put songs at the end of the set that we call like bailout songs. Yeah. It's like, if we're way too long on time, we're going to cut those two and cut right to the end.
Yeah.
Bailout.
But we can do all of them. Yay! So if you're liking what you're seeing, what you're hearing, please, please, please go check us out. We are LC Binks. LC like the cow. Binks like the cat. You know the reference? Are there enough millennials in the room?
No.
You know the reference? You have secondhand embarrassing meant for me right now.
Just grab your phone and voice to text LC Binks. You'll find it that way.
She's like, I'm a Gen Z.
You're so cheap.
I'm not a millennial. Don't put me in that group.
For jams.
Ready?
Yep.
Okay.
Go. You're a bully.
Oh,
boss or somebody you work with is just a fucking bully. Just an asshole. That's
stupid.
Who that's, just stupid, yeah. That's what that song is written about. Somebody who's just a fucking bully of a person.
Sorry.
It's okay.
I wanted to call the song Butthole because you
it doesn't have the same rhyme.
Yeah.
Butthole.
Butthole.
He is a butthole. Can you imagine? Really, all you are is a butthole.
Wink, wink, butthole.
Yeah, I mean, maybe an edit, maybe a remix.
We're going to follow that song up with our next one called We Shot Him Dead.
the next one is actually one of the ones we had to pull if we had to, but we don't, because we're good. So I'll talk a little bit about it since we have time. So this next one is called Everything About It. It's one of, because we're, I'll, let me rewind. It's late, okay?
And you're wearing yellow.
And I'm wearing yellow, you're right. So this song was actually one of the first songs this particular exact group of people cut together.
Yeah.
Because when you're a band for 10 years, you have personnel changes and things happen, you know? People leave, people join. You see,
the cool people stay, the dick faces leave.
I said buttholes in and out.
Yeah, that. So this next song was actually like the first one that...
Wait, did I say that in the microphone?
It's fine.
Okay.
It's fine. We're family now.
Yeah.
It's been like 7 years right here, I think, this lineup, right?
8 for me.
Yeah.
But this is exactly
lineup. Oh, but
lineup.
Yeah, it was 7, yeah.
Yeah.
6 foot 7.
Yeah, and so...
So, huh.
So this one is, first of all, very important.
Longer than my marriage, I think, lasted now.
I like the woo!
We won!
Yeah, all the divorcees out there, yeah!
Woo! All right, we win!
I'm joking. But I'm actually serious. I think I've been in the band longer than my marriage lasted now.
I think you're right.
Ah! I showed her, didn't I?
Here we are. Anyway, this song holds a lot of importance for that reason, for all those reasons. But secondly, I wrote it about my autoimmune disease. I have endometriosis. And so I always like to talk about this song because it's a lot of people think it's like a breakup song because the hook is I hate everything about it. I hate you, I hate this, I hate everything about it. But really, unfortunately, it's like an anti-love letter to my body, if that makes sense. So I always dedicate this to all the people in the room who are fighting invisible fights, or hey, it can be visible as well. Whether it's mental illness, whether it's physical illness, I see you, and you are loved, and try to remember to be kind to each other because you never fucking know what battles people are fighting on the inside.
You hear me screaming in the dark.
fast, sad song. I mean, we like fast, sad songs. It's kind of like what emo is.
Yeah.
But it's not emo. It's very fast. We actually dedicated this. So we're from Detroit, the Detroit side of Michigan. So if you're ever in the area, check our schedule, lcbanks.com. And if you need to see how to spell it, you need any merch, that's my partner in life right there, partner in crime, Trish. Go see her. She has all the merch. She gatekeeps all of that stuff. It's all hers. We can't have it either. and we will have new merch next week as well. So you're going to want to check the website after our next handful of shows. So if you know anybody in Cincinnati, you want to tell them to come to our show. We have a show next weekend in Cincinnati. We have a show in Battle Creek. We also have a show a little bit later in Toledo. What else?
The Token.
Oh, The Token in Westland. We have The Diesel. That one's not... Shh, don't tell anybody.
I don't think it's
a secret. I mean, I've been telling people. We're playing a giant Thanksgiving show at Diesel.
Well, according to the flyer, we're now known as TBA.
We're TBA, on the flyer.
From EBX to TBA.
Yeah, it's fine. But if you ever want to see any of our dates...
TBS Press Up.
I keep that shit very updated. So always check lcbanks.com for all of our upcoming dates going on.
We did the best we could with the plexiglass to keep it down.
Put the drummer in a cage.
So,
finding chemo.
Do you have any?
Yeah.
You don't have any. You have one. I might need my bag of dicks. There's a reason.
Dick pets, you need to really.
So, here's what. I know. I'm getting there. I'm getting there. I got to shock them with that statement first. Let me get there. So now I have their attention. They're like, what?
Bag of dicks, what?
What are you talking about? So we had this idea. I don't remember who had this idea. I genuinely don't know who had this idea. But this next song, well, this last song, the next and last song is called K-Bye. And it's because we were in Wisconsin one day, and me and Jen were approached by some of our fans in Wisconsin and said, have you ever written a song about unsolicited dick pics? And we're like, no, but we're going to.
Like, no, just the solicited ones.
Yeah, just the consensual ones.
Mess with it at a bar. Like,
yeah.
Go away, leave me alone.
Go away. You know, like when you're approached by somebody and you're like, I'm not into it, just like.
His name was Richard, by the way. He just wanted to send a selfie.
Yeah. It wasn't a good one.
Stop. How are you doing? What's up, bro?
Just stop.
How you doing?
Oh, my God. I knew you just
can't
stop.
Take you seriously.
It's like that. Like that. But with somebody you don't know.
Don't
it's
make
not
me
good.
Laugh at you.
And so we decided, along with K-Bye, you know, being about unsolicited dick pics, unsolicited attention, you know, somebody had the idea of putting... Give me your dick pic. It says dick on this guitar pick. And you can only get them, thank you. You can only get them at our shows. We don't sell them. So
they are unsolicited.
They are unless you consent, and you may have one. You gotta come get one from one of the guitar players who has some dick pics. I also have some more at the merch booth if anybody would like some dick pics. We will also...
You can give that one away.
Oh.
Any guitar players
dick
here?
Pic from Aaron.
No? Anybody likes
anyone
dick pics?
Care for a dick pic from Phil?
If I throw...
Just save it for a rainy day.
There you go. First dick pic of the night.
Dick pic.
Yes, first dick pic of the night. Yes. And soon we'll have nude pics too.
And actually, like, we're kind of doing a service because, like, if we inform and be like, hey, if you want to send a dick pic, send a picture of this.
Yeah. Just send isn't that, it's a great opening line, right? If you're, like, Snapchatting with somebody and, like, trying to make a joke, like, hey, you want a dick pic? And we send them a fucking pic.
Dick
on it. That might work. I'm just saying, it would work on me.
It's better than the alternative.
It's
yes.
So
yes.
Much better.
So much better.
Everybody,
I'm just saying.
Everybody send Aaron a dick pic now.
Last time.
Tag her on the socials.
I'm with a woman on purpose, okay? Of course.
She doesn't even play guitar, guys. Come on.
I did.
Go
for it. Anyway, thank you so much. We were LC Vix. This is our last tune of the night.
What, Phil?
How the song
starts? Song starts by me going. Da 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 da. Just like that, Phil.
Okay.
All right, you ready?
Yeah. Ready.
Da 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 da. Just like that, Phil.
I'm You're backstage right now. Thank you so much for tuning in. We hope you enjoyed it. Get the whole live experience. Hopefully some of you didn't stay up too late. I see a lot of you are in time zones that are not bad. Hello, I missed you all today. Thank you for tuning in. We're still working on getting all of our stuff out, but I always like to say hi and bye. Thank you all so much for the support, and I hope you enjoyed it. Mwah. I gotta pack up my stuff.